Hi, I'm Paul Martin. This is my documentary, Beautiful Australia. Enjoy and see our beautiful land. Come and visit it.
Here's one of the many pristine beaches we have along the Great Ocean Road in Victoria. Absolutely beautiful, stunning scenery. Here's some of the forest on the Great Ocean Road. It's beautiful and breathtaking. And here's a koala bear in the wild, having a good snooze. This is Castle Cove, very beautiful, breathtaking scenery. Thank you. and here are the 12 apostles. And these are the archers. Thank you. Here we are at the Triplet Falls, which is north of Cape Otway off the Great Ocean Road. And here are the Triplet Falls. This is the Cape Barren Geese, a beautiful big species of goose. They make a honking sound like a pig. And here's the black swan, Australia's native swan. And here is the black-breasted buzzard. It's found throughout most of Australia. And this is the southern stone curlew. And here is a goose and some ducks in the background. And here's the grey goshawk. Rosellas, native Australian icon of Australia's tomato sauce brands. Here's the seagulls feasting on some food scraps. Thank you. Here's the kookaburra, which is a large species of kingfisher. And it has a very distinct laugh. And here is the plumed whistling duck, a native duck of Australia. Here's the cassowary, the closest relative of the emu.
He must be lonely.
Animals on the coat of arms, the emu and the kangaroo. The reason they're on our coat of arms is because they're two animals that cannot walk backwards. Young emu chicks. And this is how the emu sits. And the emu is the second largest ratite or bird in the world. The ratites are the flightless birds. Here's an emu strutting in front of me. Or maybe they want food. And here we have the dingo, Australia's native wolf. It was actually introduced thousands of years ago. Their closest relative is the Indian wolf. They're not a marsupial, and they're the biggest mammal predator on mainland Australia. They supplanted the thylacine when they arrived in Australia. Dingoes can be black or yellow or white, and this is a rare subspecies called the Alpine dingo. And here is a white one, and they're all Alpine dingoes. There's a yellow one. Here we are near Pyramid Rock.
And here is Pyramid Rock. And there is Pyramid Rock. Isn't it beautiful? Australia's own natural pyramid. Koala bear eats only eucalyptus leaves, and he's enjoying his scrumptious meal, very satisfied. And here's an afternoon siesta for the koala.
Just hold on the tree there. It's okay, I understand we all.
Cut off your face off. Oh, look at him go.
It's so gay. Can you take a picture?
I'll try.
You need a buckle.
He's coming down.
Oh, yeah, he just moved a bit.
It's coming down.
I moved for a bit.
Oh, look at his arm.
And there off in the distance is the Nobbies, a collection of rocky islands just off the coast. And here is the Nobbies. Here we have a penguin, smallest species of penguin in the world. They're 30 centimetres long. Thank you. For as much as you may enjoy looking at this, there's no substitute for actually being there yourself. And the smell of salty water and the sea breeze. Very beautiful experience.
Thank you.
Tasmanian devil resembles the badger, but it's a marsupial, so it's not related to the badger. And here's a couple of Tasmanian devils having a good afternoon chillax. And there's the tiger cat, or quoll, a native marsupial predator that resembles a cat. Its closest relative is the Tasmanian devil. And here's some of the forests on Phillip Island, which are leading up to Ryle Inlet. And here is the Ryle Boardwalk, a swampy area. These trees here are mangroves, and they're the only trees that are able to grow between tides in thick mud where there's salty water. They have glands that secrete salt, and excess salt is concentrated in the bark and leaves, which the plant will later drop. And seedlings fall from the tree and they float on the tide until the seed takes root, usually within about 5 days.
Here we are on Churchill Island, a little island off the coast of Phillip Island. And this is the Highland cattle that have been introduced to this island. The Highland cattle are very woolly and they've got curved horns. So they're a unique tourist attraction for the region. This is Cape Woolamai on Phillip Island, ideal place for surfing. Here's a scenic lookout from outside Phillip Island. This is Wilson's Promontory National Park, a huge wildlife park in Australia. Here we have some wallabies in the wild. here's a wallaby in the wild. That's a beautiful creature. These are wallabies. They're really cute. They look like rats, but cute rats. And he's begging for food, so I'll feed him some. And here's a kangaroo. Nice soft fur. Cute. Here's the swamp wallaby. Close relative of the kangaroo. Here's another one. Here we see a whole herd of kangaroos. They're having a nice chillax. And here's a mother with a joey or a baby in its pouch. There's the joey's legs hanging out of the pouch. There's another mother, legs hanging out of the pouch as it's asleep. The wallabies and kangaroos have beautiful soft fur. Here's the swamp wallaby. Thank you. This is the Kangaroo Island kangaroo. And here they are, enjoying a nice chillax. Here's a grey kangaroo. Quite a big gangly one. And here's a herd of kangaroos feeding. And here is an albino tamer wallaby. Very cute and chillaxed. Ah. And here's another albino tamer wallaby with a galah in the background. These are the Woolshed Falls in Beechworth, Victoria. And here is the pristine gorge outside of Beechworth in Victoria. And this is Lake Nillicuti, about half an hour out of Benalla. And this lizard here is the eastern water dragon. Quite a formidable looking lizard. And this is the lace monitor. A big lizard. Sunbaking. Here we see the tortoise and the eastern water dragon. And here's the blue-tongued lizard. And this is the flying fox, Australia's native bat. And they're not marsupials, they're placentals. But they would have gotten to Australia by flying and by strong winds blowing them onto Australia long ago. That's the same way bats would have gotten to New Zealand and Hawaii, which are isolated islands.
Look at that membrane in there.
And here's the wombat, a burrowing marsupial. echidna, a monotreme. That is a mammal that lays eggs, native Australian one. Its closest relative is the only other monotreme species, the platypus. And they mostly eat ants as their diet. It does bear a resemblance to the platypus if you look carefully at it. There it is. Nice. This is New South Wales. Very scenic. And here we are in the Blue Mountains. This is just breathtaking, but seeing this on video is nowhere near as good as seeing it in real life. This is the Lura Cascade near the Three Sisters in the Blue Mountains.
here are the Three Sisters, an amazing geological phenomena. In the heart of the Blue Mountains, just outside Katoomba. And here's the Three Sisters at night time, lit up by spotlight.